at conferences throughout the world. Dr. Chapelle earned her BA in Linguistics at Michigan State University, and an MA in Teaching English as a Second Language, and a PhD in Applied Linguistics from the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign, and she joined the Iowa State University faculty in 1985. She is also the editor of the 10-volume Encyclopedia of Applied Linguistics, published in 2013, the discipline's first fully comprehensive work, and she is co-editor of the Cambridge Applied Linguistics series, considered one of the top two book series in the field. She has served as a journal editor and is president of the American Association for Applied Linguistics. Recent awards include the 2012 Lifetime Achievement Award in Language Testing and the 2012 Samuel J. Messick Memorial Lecture Award. Please join me in welcoming distinguished professor Carol Chapelle.
Thank you, President Leath, for that nice introduction. President Leath, Provost Wickard, Dean Holger, Vice Presidents, Deans of the Colleges and Faculty, parents, friends, and graduates. It is an honor to give a commencement address for the graduating class of 2013. This is a very happy day for all of us because we're so proud of you. You've worked so hard to arrive at this moment. As the graduate college class of 2013, you are 485 individuals. You came from Taiwan, the Ukraine, and Saudi Arabia. You even came from Ghana in Africa. You came from Des Moines, Mason City, Cedar Rapids, and Chicago. You came from so many different places. What brings you all here today is your achievement. You're all graduating with a degree from Iowa State University. But really, you have more in common than today's graduation. You're also united by the common vision and purpose that brought you here. After you earned your bachelor's degree 2 or 4 or 6 years ago, all of you wanted more. You wanted to go farther. For many of you, your families and friends didn't really understand. They said, hey, you've graduated, you're done with college, you can go make a lot of money now. But you had a different idea. You wanted to learn more. You had a vision for attaining a deeper understanding of your field. You didn't care about earning money, at that time anyway. You saw greater value in expanding your potential. You wanted to come to Iowa State University of Science and Technology. You wanted to learn to do research that's linked to practice, and you've succeeded brilliantly. You've done so much during your time here. You've assisted us with research and teaching. You've worked in our labs, you've taught our classes, you've shared new ideas, and formed great communities. We created a space for you here, and you filled it better than we could have imagined. And we're going to miss you. We'll miss you as you graduate into a challenging world. So I should give you some advice. Some advice about your future. Advice based on my own experience and my own academic journey. After all, I graduated from a great land-grant university in the Midwest. See, I'm wearing blue, Illinois. My education was focused on research linked to practice. I spent 6 years in graduate school teaching classes, working with professors on research, and cultivating new ideas. But that was 30 years ago. It was 1983. It was a different world then. Ronald Reagan was president. In 1983, the United States was emerging from a serious recession. I remember going home to visit my parents in Detroit, where the despair of unemployment and poverty was displayed everywhere. It was a scary recession. It was a world of uncertainty to graduate into. But back in Urbana, Illinois, things were pretty exciting. New technologies were changing our academic thinking, our teaching practices, and our lives. Computer technology had been around for a while and used somewhat in linguistics and language teaching, but this activity was really new and kind of on the edge of the discipline when I was in graduate school. Microcomputers just came on the scene during that time. It was a long time ago. I remember as a graduate student buying my first microcomputer. It was an Apple III, not a popular, long-lasting Apple II that you may have heard of, but an Apple III. It was the newest thing, and I had to have one, and it was really expensive. So how could a graduate student in linguistics buy such a cutting-edge piece of equipment? You know, don't you? Student loans, of course. So that was 1983. The uncertainty of recession, the excitement of new technologies, and student debt. Maybe there are some similarities, eh? So what did I learn? What do you do when you graduate into uncertain and exciting times? How do you navigate a world of change? How do you use and build on what you've learned in graduate school without becoming a static fixture in a changing world? This is the real challenge. The people who exceed after their graduate education are the ones who figure out how to do it. So how do you do it? Well, the specifics are going to vary across a range of circumstances that graduate school prepares us for, but some of the basics are probably the same across fields. Because for all of us, graduate education is not about learning to reproduce the ideas and methods of the previous generation. Graduate education is about learning to restudy, reconceptualize, rethink, and reinvent. In view of that, in view of your need to chart new territory, I have three pieces of advice. First, I would suggest focus on the problems of the day. Use the real-world problems in your areas of study to motivate your research. At the land-grant universities of the Midwest, we are ideally situated to frame our research in this way. We naturally think in terms of practice-oriented problem solving because we think in terms of research linked to practice. If real problems provide the impetus for programs of research, those programs will naturally chart new territory and will always be relevant. The problems keep changing. You follow the problems. My second word of advice is to keep on learning. For all that you learned in your graduate education, you probably didn't learn exactly what you're going to need to address the problems of the future. I know when I graduated, it was clear that new technologies would be a powerful force in applied linguistics and language education, but I didn't really know how. I needed to learn more, and by learning more, I've been able to reconceptualize, rethink, and reinvent. Third, think long-term. Few of the problems that we work on are amenable to instant solutions. We're the people who have the vision and depth of knowledge to work on difficult issues. And difficult issues take a long time to solve. Several years ago, when you came to Iowa State, you had a vision that extended beyond the ordinary. You were thinking beyond the next couple of months of your lives when you decided to pursue an advanced degree. Well, that wasn't your final innovative vision. That was only your first. You're the people who need to create new long-term visions for your fields. As you graduate today, you join a select group of people in the world who have an advanced degree. In the United States, for example, only 10% of Americans have a degree beyond their bachelor's, and only 1% has a Ph.D. All you people in the red robes out there, only 1% has a Ph.D. That's in the U.S. You've had the privilege to engage in advanced study in your field. As you continue on this path of privilege, you have the opportunity to provide leadership and vision for your field. On behalf of your professors at Iowa State University, I want to wish you all the best for the life of leadership and vision that your graduate degree affords you. We hope you will be successful. We hope your decision to take the road less traveled, the road to Iowa State, will pay off in the success that you cultivate in your fields and in your lives. We hope the things you have learned from us will serve as stepping stones for your future success. We hope that you'll work with integrity to use what you've learned here. We hope we were good role models for you as we struggled with the day-to-day issues in research and teaching. We hope you saw us using good judgment and treating the profession with seriousness and respect. We hope you'll take this integrity with you as you pursue your work, and we know that it will serve you well. We also hope that you'll work to create opportunities for others. Recognize the privileged position you occupy in your profession, in your state, and in your country. You're here today because you had a vision for yourself, but you also had the guidance to make your vision a reality. When you arrived here, we welcomed you, we created space for you, and we created space for your contributions. We hope that you will create space for others to learn from you in the future. We are very happy that you spent the past years with us. We thank you for your many contributions, and we wish you the very best as you chart new territory in these challenging and exciting times. Congratulations, class of 2013. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Chapelle, for your inspirational thoughts and for your outstanding service to education and to this university. We will now hear from Iowa State University's Brass Ensemble under the direction of Dr. Michael Calimo. Instead of the piece listed in the program, I'm happy to announce the Student Brass Ensemble will perform Cyclone Fantasia, which was composed especially for commencement.
President Leath will now recognize students graduating with distinction and then will present degrees to the graduates.
At this time, I call upon Senior Vice President and Provost Dr. Wickard for recognizing students graduating with distinction.
I would like to recognize at this time the graduate students who are receiving Teaching Excellence Awards and Research Excellence Awards. Students receiving these awards are being recognized tonight for outstanding teaching and for research accomplishments in a graduate program, and they are wearing cardinal and gold honor cords. Will those students please rise? On behalf of the faculty, I offer you my sincere congratulations. Be seated, please.
Provost Wickert, I now call upon you for the conferring of degrees.
We shall now proceed with the conferring of graduate degrees. Some degrees will be conferred in absentia. We'll begin with the conferring of the Doctor of Philosophy degrees, the highest degree that Iowa State University confers. Before doing so, I would like to say a few words about the history of academic attire and the special nature of the hooding ceremony tonight. Academic gowns have been part of the university experience since the 12th century and the advent of the first European universities. Because these early schools were connected to great cathedrals, like those at Bologna and Chartres, the black gown of the schoolmasters, or scholastics, emulated the somber dignity of the clergy, and it signified a life devoted to learning. In addition, the ample materials of the gown served to keep the scholars warm in the drafty environment of the medieval universities. Hoods were also functional, like the hood on a monk's habit, while colors were reserved for masters or teachers rather than the bachelors or students. Initially, the colors indicated one's discipline, such as the green of nature for medicine. Mortar boards with black or gold tassels and school colors came much later. But the clerical formality of the academic gown continues to represent the dedication and the nobility of the scholar's vocation. During the hooding ceremony this evening, the degree recipients will be escorted and hooded by their major professors, who have worked with them throughout their study for the doctoral degree. The hoods will connect the graduate with a family of scholars throughout history, from all parts of the world, and with Iowa State University. The cardinal doctorate gown and Iowa State hood worn by the PhDs this evening are Iowa State University's custom academic attire. And now, the Dean of the Graduate College, Dr. David Holger, will present candidates for the degree Doctor of Philosophy from the Graduate College.
Candidates for the degree Doctor of Philosophy, please rise. The Doctor of Philosophy is the university's highest academic degree, awarded only to those who have successfully completed an intensive and demanding course of study whose primary focus is on learning to conduct original research. The final stage of the program is the preparation and defense of a dissertation that describes the outcome of a major research project. To prepare for that project, the student must have gained expertise and skills in a particular discipline and must have thoroughly explored its existing knowledge base. Those who receive doctorates today have demonstrated that they are truly experts in their fields whose research has already contributed significantly to human knowledge. The hood they assume symbolizes their admission to the exclusive ranks of those who have earned the respect associated with the title Doctor of Philosophy. President Leath, these candidates have completed all required courses, demonstrated their ability in research, and passed all examinations. They are recommended by the graduate faculty and the faculty senate and are approved by the Board of Regents, State of Iowa, for the degree Doctor of Philosophy.
In recognition of the satisfactory completion of respective programs in the Graduate College, by the authority delegated to me by the Board of Regents, State of Iowa, I confer upon you the degree Doctor of Philosophy with its accompanying rights, privileges, and obligations. This diploma, now to be placed in your hands, and the hood with which you will be invested, shall forever be the testimony of your high academic rank. Congratulations.
Ph.D. graduates, please be seated. Faculty marshals will dismiss you by row to approach the stage. Caitlin Elizabeth Abel, co-major in animal breeding and statistics, presented by Dr. Stalder. Andrea Arias Aguirre, major in plant breeding, presented by Dr. Fay. Sunil Kumar Arola, major in aerospace engineering, presented by Dr. Durbin. Paul Lawrence Ashman, major in psychology, presented by Dr. Scott. Joan Blazer Bainziger, major in human development and family studies, presented by Dr. Russell and Dr. Margaret. Ty Jason Barton, major in crop production and physiology, presented by Dr. Moore. Cynthia Denise Bennett, major in history of technology and science, presented by Dr. Bix. Chelsea Marie Burns, major in ecology and evolutionary biology, presented by Dr. Adams. Christian Bischoff, major in materials science and engineering, presented by Dr. Martin. Eric Blumberg, major in condensed matter physics, presented by Dr. Prozorov. Nicholas James Boddicker, major in animal breeding and genetics, presented by Dr. Deckers. Michelle Lee Botcher, major in education, presented by Dr. Gansimer Toff. Kip Moore Bottenfield, major in education, presented by Dr. Sterobin. Scott Edward Boykin, major in bioinformatics and computational biology, presented by Dr. Andriotti. Jason Christopher Bueller, Major in Veterinary Microbiology, presented by Dr. Miller. Brian Anthony Campbell, Major in Genetics, presented by Dr. Hootham. David Cantu, Major in Chemical Engineering, presented by Dr. Riley. Nanning Chow, Major in Agricultural Engineering, presented by Dr. Herberg. Ramya Chandrasekhar, Major in Materials Sciences and Engineering, presented by Dr. Chumley. Ruchi Chaudhry, Major in Computer Science, presented by Dr. Fernandez Baca. Hao Chun, Major in Electrical Engineering, presented by Dr. Alaprantis. Lon Lung Chiong, Major in Hospitality Management, presented by Dr. Leong. In Su Chu, Major in Economics, presented by Dr. Orazin. Derek Jamal Kobel, Major in Genetics, presented by Dr. Lamont. Shannon Michelle Cruzen, Major in Meat Science, presented by Dr. Lonergan. Aurelio Ruiz Curbelo, Major in Education, presented by Dr. Evers. Aaron Lee Day, co-major in Soil Science and Environmental Science, presented by Dr. Horton. Could you ask him if it's Saint or Saint? Saint or Saint? Michael Davis, Major in Education, presented by Dr. Robinson. Pedro de Saint Maurice Maduro, Major in Kinesiology, presented by Dr. Welk. Lynn Doyle, Major in Bioinformatics and Computational Biology, presented by Dr. Bogdanova. Amir Durrani, Major in Hospitality Management, presented by Dr. Rajagopal. Richmond Solomon Kuezi Jaco, major in Applied Linguistics and Technology, presented by Dr. Douglas. Ibrahim Adnan El Hedak, major in Chemical Engineering, presented by Dr. Glass. Kevin Jan Esch, major in Immunobiology, presented by Dr. Peterson. Dawn Elizabeth Eystone, major in Rhetoric and Professional Communication, presented by Dr. Bakley. David Michael Failing, major in Mathematics, presented by Dr. Bergman. Benazir Fateh, major in Computer Engineering, presented by Dr. Govindarasu. Yao Fu, major in Bioinformatics and Computational Biology, presented by Dr. Dickerson. William Gerard Gall, major in Chemical Engineering, presented by Dr. Vigil. Michaeline Gherkin-Goulet, major in Forestry, presented by Dr. Thompson. Mary Njeri Gichobi, major in Education, presented by Dr. Andriotti. Angela Michelle Glosser, major in Sociology, presented by Dr. DeLisi. Krista Kalberer-Goodell, major in Veterinary Biology, Microbiology, presented by Dr. Zimmerman. Tara Lee Greenwich Pulley, major in Veterinary Microbiology, presented by Dr. Jung. Chung Guo, major in Mechanical Engineering, presented by Dr. Wickard and Dr. Ganapathy Subramanian. Jose German Guzman, major in Soil Science, presented by Dr. Al-Kaizi. Adam Lee Han, major in Computer Engineering, presented by Dr. Govindarasu. Diane K. Hargens, major in Education, presented by Dr. Ebers. Matthew J. Hawkins, major in Aerospace Engineering, presented by Dr. Wee. Melinda Sue Hines, major in Human Development and Family Studies, presented by Dr. Martin. Ignacio Hernandez, major in Education, presented by Dr. Marsh. Susana Hernandez, major in Education, presented by Dr. Gildersleeve. Laura Ann Hildreth, major in Statistics, presented by Dr. Genschel. Jerome Hilscher, major in Education, presented by Dr. Ebers. Susan Renee Hodgkins, major in Immunobiology, presented by Dr. Cohut. Amy Beth Hooksma, major in Statistics, presented by Dr. Morris. Yue Ho, major in Chemical Engineering, presented by Dr. Schneider. Shorui Hong, major in Electrical Engineering, presented by Dr. Vaswani. Yuan Yuan Hong, major in Bioinformatics and Computational Biology, presented by Dr. Wu. Lucas Mark Huntemer, major in Immunobiology, presented by Dr. Narasimhan. Joy Marie Jackson, major in Microbiology, presented by Dr. Pohl.
Where's the family? Yes. Okay.
Indria Michelle Jenkins, major in Psychology, presented by Dr. Cutrona. Eric Matthew Johnson, major in Materials Science and Engineering, presented by Dr. Chumley. Maria Levon Joseph, major in Statistics, presented by Dr. Karikiri. Kapil Kandel, major in Chemistry, presented by Dr. Sadal. Brian Douglas Kaplinger, major in Aerospace Engineering, presented by Dr. Wee. Aliyah Karabulut Igu, major in Education, presented by Dr. Crawford. Yeah. Atwar Rahim Katebi, major in bioinformatics and computational biology, presented by Dr. Jernigan. Chad Everett Key, major in education, presented by Dr. Evans. Hunsu Kim, major in condensed matter physics, presented by Dr. Prozorov. Apisit Kitawanrat, major in veterinary microbiology, presented by Dr. Zimmerman. Barbara Jean Klein, major in education, presented by Dr. Ebers. Rachel Erin Kleinschmidt, major in agricultural history and rural studies, presented by Dr. Reinie Kerberg. Laurel Beth Klickenberg, major in education, presented by Dr. Ebers. Susan Marie Canetter, major in immunobiology, presented by Dr. Sacco. Dawn Annette Coltis, major in genetics, presented by Dr. Spurlock. Kai Ling Kong, major in nutritional sciences, presented by Dr. Lenningham Foster. Sandeep Krishnan, major in computer science, presented by Dr. Lutz. Tracy Cruz, major in education, presented by Dr. Ebers and Dr. Starobin. Jessica Ann LaPaglia, major in psychology, presented by Dr. Chun. Dai Trong Lee, co-majors in education and statistics, presented by Dr. Shelley. Minsun Lee, major in apparel merchandising and design, presented by Dr. Damhorst. Catherine Ann Lerseth, major in education, presented by Dr. Cho.
His first.
Benjamin Aaron Lewis, major in bioinformatics and computational biology, presented by Dr. Dobbs. Lucas Benjamin Linz, major in microbiology, presented by Dr. Bonning. Xingfu Liu, major in aerospace engineering, presented by Dr. Liu. Shunpei Liu, major in chemical engineering, presented by Dr. Malapragada. Yong Liu, major in computer engineering, presented by Dr. Guan. Gwendolyn Michelle Allison Ludwikowski, major in psychology, presented by Dr. Armstrong. Joyce Louis, major in education, presented by Dr. Hagedorn. Dustin Paul Martin, co-majors in molecular, cellular, and developmental biology and neuroscience, presented by Dr. Kanthasamy. Diego Mejia Giraldo, major in electrical engineering, presented by Dr. McCallie. Nahed Imsaleb, major in sustainable agriculture, presented by Dr. Lewin and Dr. Kanwar. Debabata Mukherjee, major in inorganic chemistry, presented by Dr. Sadal. Ganapathy Raj Murugasam, major in nutritional sciences, presented by Dr. Persia. Bianca Marie Myers, major in education, presented by Dr. Sterobin and Dr. Ebers. Shibani Uday Naik, major in immunobiology, presented by Dr. Kohut. Akash Dev Nakarmi, co-majors in agricultural engineering and human-computer interaction, presented by Dr. Tong. Jane Michael Nargis, major in human-computer interaction, presented by Dr. Townsend. Darla Nibelink Struck, major in education, presented by Dr. Ebers. Josephat Kichobi Joka, Major Animal Science, presented by Dr. Hoffman. Maciel Oriana, Major in Plant Breeding, presented by Dr. Karakiri. Zachary James Oster, Major in Computer Science, presented by Dr. Basu. Susan Paniak, Major in Rhetoric and Professional Communication, presented by Dr. Blakely. Carl Timothy Leroy Pasternak, Major in Statistics, presented by Dr. Morris. Mark Richard Peltz, Major in Education, presented by Dr. Evers. Larissa Oliveira Pires, Major in History of Technology and Science, presented by Dr. Biggs. Brian Christopher Post, Major in Psychology, presented by Dr. Wade. Chunlu Chu, Major in Electrical Engineering, presented by Dr. Vaswani. Wu Chu, Major in Statistics, presented by Dr. Vardaman. Parameshwaran Ramanan, Major in Biochemistry, presented by Dr. Amarha Singh. Jacob Davis Rawlins, Major in Rhetoric and Professional Communications, presented by Dr. Wilson. Linda B. Wallen Reddington, Major in Education, presented by Dr. Evers. Marjorie Ruth Rover, Major in Biorenewable Resources and Technology, presented by Dr. Brown. Purnima Ruberu, Major in Chemistry, presented by Dr. Vela. Michelle Elaine Ruse, Major in Computer Science, presented by Dr. Basu. Sai Kirunmai Samudrala, Major in Mechanical Engineering, presented by Dr. Ganapathy Subramanian. Deborah Kimberly Sanborn, Major in Education, presented by Dr. Robinson. Donald Grant Schofstall, Major in Hospitality Management, presented by Dr. Arendt. Nkung Nam Shu, major in apparel, merchandising, and design, presented by Dr. Fiore. Sugam Kumar Sharma, major in computer science, presented by Dr. Gadia and Dr. Tim. Aaron Trask Shelman, major in civil engineering, presented by Dr. Sritharam. Bradley Scott Shutters, major in computer science, presented by Dr. Fernandez Baca. Paul Daniel Blums Grady, major in ecology and evolutionary biology, presented by Dr. Dinsmore. Kate Elizabeth Small, major in human development and family studies, presented by Dr. Margaret. Teresa Ann Smith, major in education, presented by Dr. Robinson. Crystal Ann Stanley, major in education, presented by Dr. Ebers. Ryan Thomas Sturms, major in biochemistry, presented by Dr. Hargrove. Paul Summer, major in animal nutrition, presented by Dr. Trinkle. Ruslan Suvorov, major in applied linguistics and technology, presented by Dr. Chapelle. Ryan Keith Swanson, major in chemical engineering, presented by Dr. Glatz. Wanda K. Sintelin, major in education, presented by Dr. Ebers. Shu Ru Tai, major in applied linguistics and technology, presented by Dr. Hegelheimer. Chun Chuen Tong, major in applied mathematics, presented by Dr. Lieberman. Mark Francis Tanyan, major in computer engineering, presented by Dr. Jacobson. Ting Wei T, major in chemical engineering, presented by Dr. Shanks. Ye Tian, major in statistics, presented by Dr. Meeker. John Carl Timmerman, major in hospitality management, presented by Dr. Jung. Xu Yong Tu, major in agricultural engineering, presented by Dr. Tong. Unku Fatima Unku Zanail Abidin, major in hospitality management, presented by Dr. Arendt. Li Wen Wong, major in materials science and engineering, presented by Dr. Beckman. Zhao Wong, major in mechanical engineering, presented by Dr. Kilkar. Ning Wong, major in civil engineering, presented by Dr. Ellis. Chi Wong, major in agricultural engineering, presented by Dr. Yu. Kira Melissa Werstein, major in kinesiology, presented by Dr. Smiley Oyen. Sean Douglas Whitaker, major in nuclear physics, presented by Dr. Rosati. Kristen Leanne Woods, major in education, presented by Dr. Stelrobin. Patrick John Wilcock, co-major in agricultural engineering and biorenewable resources and technology, presented by Dr. Brown. Fang Jung Yong, major in economics, presented by Dr. Orazim. Hai Lan Yong, major in economics, presented by Dr. Lappin. Steven Lee Yaninis, major in condensed matter physics, presented by Dr. Prozorov. Chad Lewis Yoder, major in animal science, presented by Dr. Boss. Hui Yu, major in applied mathematics, presented by Dr. Liu. Silan Yu, major in genetics, presented by Dr. Beatty. Ezahi Urdakul, major in civil engineering, presented by Dr. Taylor and Dr. Ceylon. Yen Zheng, major in aerospace engineering, presented by Dr. Sarkar. Stephanie Zawicki, major in education, presented by Dr. Blumenfeld. James McAfee, major in rhetoric and professional communication, presented by Dr. Crosby.
Congratulations, doctors. Candidates for master's degrees, please rise. The master's degree is awarded to those who have successfully completed an intensive course of study in a particular discipline. Reflecting the diversity of ways in which advanced knowledge and skills can be obtained, the university awards a variety of master's degrees with specific names and expectations. In many fields, a master's degree represents the highest academic achievement, and degree holders are accorded full recognition as practitioners of its art. The master's degree often involves research and the preparation of a thesis or creative component that demonstrates an ability to conduct original inquiry. All of those who receive their degrees today have demonstrated a dedication to learning and to enhancing their abilities to contribute to society. Their degrees demonstrate that they have truly mastered a complex and demanding body of knowledge. President Leath, these candidates have completed the requirements prescribed by their respective degree programs. They are recommended by the graduate faculty and the Faculty Senate and are approved by the Board of Regents, State of Iowa, for their master's degrees.
In recognition of the satisfactory completion of your respective programs in the Graduate College, by the authority delegated to me by the Board of Regents, State of Iowa, I confer upon you the master's degree with its accompanying rights, privileges, and obligations. Congratulations.
Master's candidates, please be seated. Faculty marshals will dismiss you by row to approach the stage.
Sounds good.
Brian Dean Rank, Master of Science in Agricultural Education.
Nacy Lee, Masters of Science Journalism and Mass Communication.
Timothy Marquis, Master of Science in Meteorology.
Laportia Chantel Davis, Masters of Science, Apparel Merchandising and Design.
Amy Danielle Schuss, Master of Science in Microbiology.
Leah Brene Jackson, Master's of Science in Agricultural Education.
Jeffrey Allen Kramer, Master of Science in Information Assurance.
Matthew Robert House, Master's of Public Administration.
Robert D. and Rachel Ann Beyer, Master's of Arts in History and Master of Arts in Political Science.
Julie Ann Thielen, Master's of Science, Agricultural Education.
Christine Michelle Maurer, Master of Science in Wildlife Ecology and Environmental Science.
Benjamin Ross Covington, Master's of Science in Industrial and Agricultural Technology.
Ryan Gokin, Master of Science in Sustainable Agriculture.
Nicholas Richard Henerich, Master's of Science in Transportation.
Jenny Dorothea Heath, Master of Family and Consumer Sciences.
Joshua Thomas Claypool, Master's of Science in Agricultural Engineering.
Jonathan Allen Fitzpatrick, Master of Education.
Tricia A. Henderson, Master's of Arts in English.
Randall Allen Shons, Master of Engineering in Systems Engineering.
Jacqueline E. Herman, Master's of Arts, Rhetoric, Composition, and Professional Communication.
Jesse Wayne Queen, Master of Science in Information Assurance.
Amy Catherine Bly Walton, Master's of Science, Teaching English as a Second Language, Applied Linguistics.
Timothy Martin Linnell, Master of Science in Economics.
Joshua Joseph Sasida, Master's of Arts, Rhetoric and Composition, Professional Communication.
Sean Michael O'Shea, Master of Community and Regional Planning.
David W. Thompson, Master's of Public Administration.
Clint Edward Moody, Master of Engineering in Mechanical Engineering.
Sarah Nicole McGrath, Master's of Engineering in Systems Engineering.
Louis Bernard Thompson, Master of Science in Soil Science.
Oloa Bagamisla Ogunanaki, Master's of Engineering, Systems Engineering.
Adrienne Marie Nelson, Master of Architecture.
Geetha Tumala, Master's of Science, Interdisciplinary Graduate Studies.
Unyan Lei, Master of Architecture.
Jinji Yang, Master's of Science in Sociology.
Benjamin Daniel Bircher, Master of Architecture.
Liqui Huang, Master's of Science in Sociology.
Carl Bernard Hennig, Master of Architecture.
Wendell Kenneth Johnson, Master's of Science in Information Assurance and Computer Engineering.
Desiree Nicole Miller, Master of Education.
Jill A. Sherwood, Master's of Science, Ecology and Evolutionary Biology.
Kyle Ross McKenna, Master of Engineering in Mechanical Engineering.
Mercy Kasazi Kabuama, Master's of Science, Crop Production and Physiology.
Qin Li, Master of Accounting.
Casey James Powers, Master's in Engineering in Systems Engineering.
Leonard Bell, Master of Education.
Jason Howell Hart, Master's of Science in Plant Biology.
Tracy Lynn Davis, Master of Education.
Tyler Christian Reedy, Master's of Arts in History and Master's of Art in Political Science.
H. Teresa Cresci, Master of Education.
Nicole Janae Frazee, Master's in Science and Education.
Jasmine Almoyed, Master of Arts in Political Science.
Amy L. Mueller, Master's of Science, Human Development and Family Studies.
Lisa Ann Fulkin, Master of Education.
Amy Elaine Fitzgerald, Master's of Education.
Michelle Batista da Silva, Master of Science in Plant Pathology.
Stephanie Gabrielle Carrara, Master of Science in Psychology.
Jeremy Robert Hadler, Master of Science in Statistics.
Michael James Patterson, Master of Science in Computer Engineering.
G.M. Aguilar Rodriguez, Master of Engineering in Systems Engineering.
Vinod Laxman Fanouk, Master of Engineering in Mechanical Engineering.
Connor R. Schenk, Master of Science in Computer Science and Human-Computer Interaction.
Ashley Marie Horsch, Master of Science, Food Science and Meat Science.
John Mark Artist, Master of Agriculture in Professional Agriculture.
Nathaniel John Van E, Masters of Engineering and Mechanical Engineering.
Patrick Jeremy Morrissey, Master of Science in Information Assurance and Computer Engineering.
Kelly Ann Kendrick, Masters of Education.
Jorui Lee, Master of Science in Food Science and Technology.
Michelle K. Cowell, Masters of Education.
Marika Nicole Seaman, Master of Science in Food Science and Technology.
Marissa Emily Dahl, Masters of Education.
Samantha Bristol, Master of Science in Geology.
Carrie M. Hillman, Masters of Education.
Jacob Allen Smokovitz, Master of Science in Geology and Environmental Science.
Jordan Thomas Eggerly, Masters of School Mathematics.
Anne Eileen Griesel, Master of Business Administration.
Eric James Smith, Masters of Education.
Yan Wong, Master of Science in Sociology.
Daniel Michael DeFoster, Masters of Architecture.
Rania Fateh Mohammed, Master of Arts in Teaching English as a Second Language and Applied Linguistics.
Daniel A. Humke, Masters of Science in Electrical Engineering.
Jamie Lynn Wilkin, Master of Arts in Teaching English as a Second Language and Applied Linguistics.
Amanda Jacqueline Havel, Masters of Architecture.
Stephanie Ann Laird, Master of Education.
Adam Zachary Ninneman, Masters of Architecture.
Crystal Marie Wolfer, Master of Education.
Gregory Stephen Ulrich, Masters of Architecture.
Katie Ann Weber, Master of Education.
Michael Tyler Thole, Masters of Architecture.
Melissa Lynn Schulze, Master of Education.
Shamir Garcia Torrido, Masters of Architecture.
Douglas Dale Klein, Master of Education.
Andrew David Sundahl, Masters of Architecture.
Kim Diane Langholtz, Master of Education.
Nathan Richard Scott, Masters of Architecture.
Rianne Renee Ritland, Master of Science in Journalism and Mass Communication.
Bethany Jean Junkie, Masters of Science, Mechanical Engineering and Human-Computer Interaction.
Samantha Lou Irvin, Master of Science in Environmental Science.
Travis L. Martin, Masters of Engineering and Systems Engineering.
Matthew Glenn Morton II, Master of Science in Interdisciplinary Graduate Studies.
Samuel Day Almeida, Masters of Engineering in Systems Engineering.
Laura Jennifer Kleiman, Master of Science in Sustainable Agriculture.
Juan Carlos Calderon, Masters of Education.
Chun Dong, Master of Science in Kinesiology.
Michael Charles Kokasik, Masters of Science in Meteorology.
Megan Ann Lambmeyer, Master of Science in Materials Science and Engineering.
Rita Lynn Menicki, Masters of Fine Arts in Graphics Design.
John Lewis Lambmeyer, Master of Science in Materials Science and Engineering.
Mariah Rose Smith, Masters of Arts in Graphics Design.
Tracy Jo Troutner, Master of Science in Transportation.
Li Chi Huang, Masters of Education.
Cindy Kendall, Master of Public Administration.
Young Yu Chung, Masters of Science in Computer Engineering.
Tina Kong Hildebrandt Shaw, Master of Public Administration.
Jacob Robert Pitchelman, Masters of Science in Civil Engineering.
Sherry M. Greiner, Master of Agriculture and Professional Agriculture.
Sean Elliott Connor, Masters of Engineering in Civil Engineering.
Lisa Diane Grantham, Master of Science in Interdisciplinary Graduate Studies.
Aaron Bruce Pauls, Masters of Education.
Colleen Nicole Sheriff, Master of Education.
Tandem Lee Escheld, Masters of Education.
Miranda Ann Van Cleve, Master of Education in Education.
Kevin Earl Oswald, Masters of Education.
Elise Christine Brimmeyer, Master of Education.
Mark Allen Adams, Masters of Education.
Wongti Lan Tran, Master of Science in Environmental Science.
Stacy Pauline Wood, Masters of Education.
Kelly Jo Carnine, Master of Family and Consumer Sciences.
Jamie Marie Hart, Masters of Education.
Diana Rose DeFabio, Master of Science in Nutritional Sciences.
Dana Lee Kuhl, Masters of Business Administration.
Jason A. Murphy, Master of Science in Condensed Matter Physics.
Erica Susan Velasco, Masters of Science in Civil Engineering.
Rebecca Alice Wokibula, Master of Science in Agronomy.
Robert Patrick Jameson, Masters of Arts in History.
Kyle D. Redfern, Master of Science in Mechanical Engineering.
Elizabeth R. Shellman, Masters of Science in Civil Engineering.
Christopher James Pelzer, Master of Science in Soil Science.
Timothy M. Winkler, Masters of Science in Aerospace Engineering.
Ellen Jordan Harstack, Master of Science in Information Assurance.
Zachary Adam Simons, Masters of Agriculture and Professional Agriculture.
Curtis Michael Putney, Master of Science in Information Assurance.
Nicole Suzanne Ryan, Masters of Science in Interdisciplinary Graduate Studies.
Matthew Edward Sullivan, Master of Science in Information Assurance and Computer Engineering.
Amanda Jeanette Hall, Masters of Fine Arts in Integrated Visual Arts.
Amy Elizabeth Bauer, Master of Science in Materials Science and Engineering.
Pooja Nitin Mapasekar, Masters of Science in Computer Engineering.
Chao Luo, Master of Engineering in Civil Engineering.
Byun Wook Kim, Masters of Science in Journalism and Mass Communication.
Shijie Hu, Master of Science in Civil Engineering.
Mary Louise Stokeland, Masters of Arts in English.
Jipong Chu, Master of Engineering in Civil Engineering.
Nathan Lee Pillman, Masters of Fine Arts in Creative Writing and Environment.
Asitha B. Senavirtani, Master of Science in Civil Engineering.
Teresa Jean Sherwood, Masters of Education.
Kali Hiev Engi Funga, Master of Science in Civil Engineering.
Jason Christopher Wiegand, Masters of Education.
Patricio Javier Espinoza, Master of Science in Information Systems.
Ola A. Ibrahim, Masters of Education.
Bichaya Patana Anek, Master of Science in Civil Engineering.
Annie Pierre, Masters of Education in Education.
Randy Patanati Pepino, Master of Science in Computer Science.
Amanda R. Barboza, Masters of Education.
Elise Janet McLaurin, Master of Science in Industrial Engineering.
Elliot Nolan DeVore, Masters of Education.
Dong Y. McDaniel, Master of Science in Applied Mechanics.
Margaret Elise Miller, Masters of Education.
Sethu Bharat Viswanathan, Master of Science in Industrial Engineering.
Aaron Jeffrey Freeland, Masters of Education.
Shiram Nagarajan, Master of Science in Computer Engineering.
Brian Bernard Vanderheiden, Masters of Education.
Auswin George Thomas, Master of Science in Electrical Engineering.
Michael Corey Peacock, Masters of Education.
Courtney William McCauley, Master of Engineering in Mechanical Engineering.
Leif Eric Olson, Masters of Education.
Stephanie Ann Shuey, Master of Education.
Kirk M. Wilson, Masters of Education.
Ashley Elizabeth Berneman, Master of Education.
Yon Yu Shin, Masters of Education in Apparel, Merchandising and Design.
Elise Emily Gieschen, Master of Education.
Roy Chung, Masters of Science in Industrial Engineering.
Annie Marie Olson, Master of Education.
Siki Zhu, Masters of Science in Industrial Engineering.
Karel Dora Kofax, Master of Education.
Lan Zhao, Masters in Science and Family Consumer Sciences.
Eric J. Call, Master of Education.
Xu Liu, Masters of Landscape Architecture.
Timothy Vernon Hall II, Master of Education.
Diang Yu, Masters of Engineering and Industrial Engineering.
Nathaniel Luis Olmeda, Master of Education.
Matthew Kenny, Masters of Science, Kinesiology.
Sandra I. Rosado Montilla, Master of Science in Genetics.
Miriam M. Blom Schrod, Masters of Science in Kinesiology.
Dmitry Vladimirovich Galenko, Master of Science in Computer Science.
Hannah Joy Deering, Masters of Science in Computer Human-Computer Interaction.
Rishali Chaplot, Master of Science.
Patrick Finley, Masters of Fine Arts in Graphics Design.
Dipan Prabhu Babu, Master of Science in Computer Science and Human-Computer Interaction.
Shelley Jane Altmans, Masters of Community and Regional Planning.
Lisa Renee Chernagel, Master of Accounting.
Anupreet Kaur Minhas, Masters of Community and Regional Planning.
Amanda K. Scavo, Master of Accounting.
Yuen Ho, Masters of Community and Regional Planning.
Yu Chi Chong, Master of Science in Hospitality Management.
Iman Ahmed Hamed Shoaib, Masters of Community and Regional Planning.
Kelly Marie Mullaney, Master of Science in Psychology.
Brandon F. Moeller, Masters of Science in Industrial Engineering.
Xuan Gi, Master of Science in Aerospace Engineering.
John Michael Mullen, Masters of Science in Civil Engineering.
Dao Lin, Master of Engineering in Mechanical Engineering.
Vincent Kalewata, Masters of Engineering in Industrial Engineering.
Wanjun Lee, Master of Science in Civil Engineering.
Adam Kenneth Wilkie, Masters of Science in Sociology and Sustainable Agriculture.
Bing Yu, Master of Science in Civil Engineering.
John Lindstrom, Masters of Fine Arts in Creative Writing and Environment.
Chongting Lee, Master of Science in Civil Engineering.
Pamela Jean Holt, Masters of Arts in Rhetoric, Composition, and Professional Communication.
Benjamin Greg Durbin, Master of Education.
Corey Byrne, Masters of Fine Arts in Creative Writing and Environment.
Gojo Drofenu, Master of Science in Economics.
Sarah Burke, Masters of Fine Arts in Creative Writing and Environment.
Michael Eugene Yurian, Master of Landscape Architecture.
Yiren Zhao, Masters of Science in Journalism and Mass Communication.
Xin Shi, Master of Science in Transportation.
Shenyan Shan, Masters of Science in Journalism and Mass Communication.
Kristen Elaine Bass, Master of Science in Immunobiology.
Rami M. Kabar, Masters of Education.
Srinath Reddy Kistampali, Master of Science in Mechanical Engineering.
Javier Cavazos, Masters of Fine Arts, Creative Writing and Environment.
Joel Limo Kozgi, Master of Accounting.
Kian Son, Masters of Science in Sociology.
Yu Yang Jun, Master of Science in Journalism and Mass Communication.
Zeng Zong, Masters of Science, Applied Mathematics.
Herman Pinedes, Master of Engineering in Systems Engineering.
Anthony Cy Brewer, Masters of Public Administration in Public Administration.
Chongqi Chang, Master of Engineering in Electrical Engineering.
Vignaraj Prithoff, Masters of Business Administration.
Hong Chan, Master of Arts in Interior Design.
Chandra Chija Kilaru, Masters of Science in Civil Engineering.
Qing Liu, Master of Science in Education.
Christopher Lee Miller, Masters of Science in Mechanical Engineering.
Lei Chun, Master of Fine Arts in Graphic Design. Xu Jue Feng Chun, Master of Architecture. Shi Chen, Master of Science in Journalism and Mass Communication. Aleka Kiran Koralalamantani, Master of Science in Civil Engineering. Venkata Dharma Kolipara, Master of Science in Civil Engineering. Chia He, Master of Science in Apparel, Merchandising, and Design. Zhou Yun Li, Master of Science in Journalism and Mass Communication.
Congratulations again to all our graduates.
It is now my pleasure to introduce Mr. Jeff Johnson, President of the ISU Alumni Association, to welcome you as the newest alumni of Iowa State University.
By now you know that you are now mine. Good evening, class of 2013, and congratulations on receiving your advanced degrees tonight from Iowa State University. For some of you, I know this is your second or third degree from Iowa State, and for others, this is your first degree. But for all of you, you will be Iowa State alumni far longer than you were students. So I encourage you to remain loyal, involved, and well-connected to each other and to this very special place. Tonight, I encourage you to be alumni and not just graduates. And you may ask yourself, what's the difference between graduates of Iowa State and alumni of Iowa State? ISU graduates simply hold a degree from the university. But ISU alumni, on the other hand, hold both a degree from and affection for the institution. It is my hope that you have a soft spot in your heart for Iowa State because of the time, talents, and treasures you invested in this place and that it too invested in you. Helen Keller said it best, what we once enjoyed and deeply loved, we can never lose, for all that we love deeply becomes a part of us. You see, whether you know it or not, or care to acknowledge it, this place is a part of you, and it has affected you. Just think about how we all felt after the bad calls in basketball this year, or the wins over Iowa last year, and the Oklahoma State football win a year earlier, or how we felt when one of Iowa State's faculty members won a Nobel Prize, or how it felt to see our campus and our city flooded. In other words, taking the good with the bad, Iowa State and Ames have been great places to learn, to grow, and to excel. No matter what you do or where you go, you will always be a cyclone. And for those of us who work for the university, we will continue to be interested in what you do and what you become. Furthermore, no university can ever become truly great without a large body of well-informed, closely knit, well-involved family of alumni. Alumni were largely responsible for what you found when you came to Iowa State, and they continued to invest in your success while you were here. You sat in state-of-the-art classrooms, studied under and with named professors, and witnessed groundbreaking investments in research, teaching, and outreach. As alumni, you too will have a role to play in determining the future of this great and ever-changing university. You will also assist us in defining what your children, your grandchildren, and children of other families will find when they too matriculate to Iowa State. So plan now to do your part to keep Iowa State progressing toward greater levels of excellence. In order that you may keep in touch with Iowa State and your friends during the coming years, I want to personally invite you to join the ranks of the more than 50,000 other alumni, students, and friends who are currently members of the association. Through your membership, you will be raising your hand to say that I am a partner with Iowa State, and I join with the more than 227,000 other living alumni who live in all 99 counties of Iowa, all 50 states of the U.S. and the District of Columbia, as well as more than 144 other countries. And as the second largest dues paying alumni association in the Big 12 Conference, we are eager to serve you. Your membership will give you quarterly access to Visions Magazine, as well as an opportunity to use the online directory. In order for you to start enjoying the benefits, our board of directors did approve a special membership rate of $30 for you in order to join. You will hear from me soon, so do not delete my emails or throw away my mail. If you move, be sure to let our office know, and if you don't, we'll find you anyway. You can also update your own information through our website. And if you need to locate the names and addresses of other alumni anywhere in the world at any time, you'll have 24-hour access to the online directory. My wish is that each of you will have every good measure of success, enjoy great health, and immense happiness. For you tonight are forever Iowa State and mine. Thank you.
Thank you, Jeff. We're now nearing the conclusion of our spring semester graduate commencement ceremony. I want to again thank our commencement speaker, Dr. Carol Chapelle, for her remarks and for her outstanding contributions as a faculty member and as a scholar. I also want to extend my personal congratulations to all of our graduates, recipients of advanced degrees from Iowa State University. We are all extremely proud of you and what you have accomplished. The diploma you have received is from one of the nation's finest educational institutions and leading research universities. Iowa State University is dedicated to the highest levels of academic excellence, and your diploma is a symbol of your success in achieving the high standards of excellence that this institution has established for recipients of its advanced degrees. Display it with pride, and use it with pride, for it is now a symbol of your own excellence and academic achievement. Now, before we close, we also wish to recognize the hard work of many others who made this day possible. The faculty and staff, family members, and the many friends who have supported these graduates. So I now ask the graduates to please rise and look to your family and friends in the audience and show them your support. And now, if the audience will rise, I'll ask you, the family and friends of these accomplished graduates of this great university, to show them your support one more time. I ask you to please remain standing as we near the end of this commencement ceremony, and to please remain standing as the platform party recesses. Thank you for being a part of this very important, significant occasion. And now, with the singing of the Bells of Iowa State by music major Daniel Ellis, I pronounce the spring 2013 graduate college commencement at a close.
Please join me in singing the Bells of Iowa State. You will find the words printed on the back of your program.
And for Say large ego instrument.